Welcome to Maya Hacks. In this video tutorial, we will see how to animate a giant walk. I'll be referring animator survival kit's walk poses, and we'll animate camera or set the camera for the said animation. So we'll try to understand the way it shifts in animating the enormous or giant characters, and also understand the timing of these characters. So to start with, I've got the shadows in the viewport. That is because I've enabled the use all lights option, and I've enabled the shadows here. And also I've created two lights. One is a directional light, and I've got another light which is an ambient light. So I switch the display of these lights to off, and I've got a icon here in the shelf. By just selecting that, you can select all the controls. So to start with, I will set up the contact pose first on frame number one. I select the control and move forward and backward for the other leg, and create the contact pose. I'm moving the main control here, and I'll select this foot control and raise the foot roll value. And for this also, I choose the foot roll and foot break. I move this foot control so that I get straight legs there on the contacts. So I'll do a set key by pressing S on the keyboard, and I'll put my time slider to 25 frames, and on 25th frame I'll do a set key. So I got a keyframe on frame number 1, I got a keyframe on frame number 25 where I could see this pose here. On frame number 13, I swap the legs. The leg which is in the front will go back, and the leg which is in the back will go front. So don't make or copy the values. Try to keep things symmetrical or asymmetrical. Sorry. So I'll see which leg is in the front. So I go to frame number 7, which is the breaking point, breakdown pose for this two poses. So on frame number 7, I set the foot roll values 0 and move this up and make sure that the leg is straight enough. This is a normal way of setting up the pose with the survival kit, but in this particular case, I would like to select the control, move it side, so which will allow me to give the weight shifts for the character, and then I'll rotate this back as well. And also I'll just move this a little bit. So this should be the passing pose. Then I go to the frame number 19. I select this control, make this value 0. Move it up, rotate back. Move this leg up, rotate down. And also I just move this sidewards. The knee control need to be animated accordingly. So I got this. So weight shifts is nothing but the pelvis, the body control right now is in the middle of the two legs. When the body is now taken over by the one leg, the body has been shifted this side. So the shifting of the weights is what I'm talking about. Okay, now we'll further break before that. So I go to frame number 4. I select this control, move this control down. Maybe I'll just rotate it. You see. Okay, setting the pose accordingly. Maybe I can just break the toe a little bit. Breaking toe gives me the penetration. It's okay. Fine. I'll do a set key here, then I break this pose here at frame number 16. Select this control, set the foot roll value to 0, move it down, values to 0 again. Move it up. Set a key. So the another pose would come at frame number 10, which is the up pose. So select this control, increase the foot roll value, and then move the body up. And this control here, I will rotate this way so that I get the anticipation of the landing. Yeah. So I'll do a set key here. So go to frame number 22. The idea is to give 2 frames for every pose here. I move it up. So you get that basic, this leg has got some problem. The leg looks very snappy while it's lifting, so trying to reduce the amount of change that will give the control on the timing. Okay, once I've got this, I will select all the controls, do a set key. Okay, I'll open the dope sheet and I'll change the timing which I was talking about. So I'll just increase the timing between the down pose to passing pose. I'll put 5 frames here and 5 frames here. Contact, down, passing, up, contact. And here again 5 frames. And here again 5 frames. So once I've changed the timing, the way things look different here. There are some issues with the way the foot is, but the whole idea is to understand the concept. So what I do is I just create a camera here and set the focal length to 10, because I just want to put a low a wide lens, and I put it on the ground like that. Now once that is done, I just go to the frame number 1 here. I select the camera and key it, and this is the place where he's putting up the foot, the right foot. You get that sudden vibration in the ground or the camera. I do this on the frame number 19 to 22. So I set a key with the normal placement, but on 22 I move it down, on 21 I move it up. So that gives that effect. So switch off the camera and do a play blast there. So I just enable the loop. Okay, this is to give an idea on how to deal with this sort of giant thing. So camera, posing, weight shift. There are details which we need to work on, especially work on the graph editor. We need to work on the polish and timing also. There are some fine details missing out, but it's an overview of this situation. Thank you.